Hello, today I'm going to show you how to use the new grid repeat function. Let's open a new document, change the stroke to none, and draw a triangle. Select the polygon tool, click on the artboard, and drag your mouse out. While you are dragging your mouse, press the down arrow key on your keyboard a few times to reduce the number of sides to 3. With the triangle selected, go to Object. Here you will find a new function called Repeat. It is only available with the new version of Illustrator. Now select Grid. You will notice that Illustrator automatically creates a grid repeat that consists of 8 instances. Drag the handle on the side to add more columns, or the handle on the bottom to add more rows. Drag the tab slider to increase or decrease the horizontal spacing in grid, or the side slider to increase or decrease the vertical spacing. We can do the same by using the horizontal or vertical spacing in grid controllers from the tab toolbar or from the properties panel. If your properties panel is not showing, go to Window and choose Properties. And adjust the spacing here. Use the selection tool to reposition the grid. We can change the grid type to brick by row or brick by column. We can also flip rows or columns by using these options. Let's change the grid type to brick by row. Now change the horizontal and vertical spacing in grid to 0. If you wish, adjust the sidebars a little bit more. To edit the grid, first make sure it is selected and then double-click on it. This will take us to the grid repeat isolation mode. Here we can move our triangle, rotate it, change its color, adjust the number of sides on our polygon, or add a stroke. Possibilities are endless. To exit the grid repeat isolation mode, click on layer 1 and the arrow, or press the escape key on your keyboard. We can still edit our grid by selecting it and modifying the grid repeat properties. Under grid type, let's select brick by column and adjust the spacing a little bit more. If we decide to get rid of our grid, go to Object, Repeat, and choose Release. This will take us to the original shape. Let's undo it. And of course, if we would like to make any changes to an individual shape in the grid, we can always go to Object and expand everything. Now I will show you how to create this flag using the grid repeat function. First, create a new document. Here are the colors I will be using. Press the letter M for the rectangle tool and single click on the artboard. Type 200 for the width and 72 for the height. Let's align this rectangle to the upper left corner and extend its width to the other side. With the red rectangle selected, go to Object, choose Repeat, and select Grid. We only need the first column. Let's get rid of the other columns by dragging the side handle all the way to the end of our artboard. Now drag the bottom handle to align it with the bottom of our artboard. Let's drag the side slider to decrease the number of red stripes to 7. And use the vertical spacing in grid controller from the tab toolbar for the more precise adjustment. Let's lock this layer to prevent it from shifting. Next, select blue and draw a rectangle in the upper left corner. Zoom in. Use the Direct Selection tool, click on this anchor point and align it with this intersection. And do the same with the other side. Let's select this layer as well. Click away to deselect. Now change the fill to white and draw a small star. With the star selected, go to Object, Repeat and choose Grid. And like we did previously, drag the horizontal and vertical sliders to adjust the spacing in the grid. Let's change the grid type to Brick by Row. Move the grid to the left so the upper tab star is in the corner and adjust the spacing so there is 6 stars at the top and 5 stars on the side. Next, move the grid to the side and we will do some final adjustments. Let's move the sidebar to the left so these stars are not showing. Now go to Object and choose Expand. Click away to deselect and using the Direct Selection tool, select the stars that need to be removed and then press the Delete key on your keyboard. Or we can select the Lasso tool, switch to the Outline mode, select the stars on the side and then press the Delete key. Let's turn off the Outline mode. Next, we need to make sure that the bounding box fits tightly around our stars. To do this, with the stars selected, go to Pathfinder and choose Merge. Finally, we will align the stars with the blue rectangle. First, unlock the blue rectangle layer. Now select the stars and the blue rectangle, then click on the blue rectangle to mark it as a key object. Open the Align panel and choose Horizontal and Vertical Align Center. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.